the deviation of the 4, 5, 3, or 7 groups. Okay, and in my investigated case, using cluster analysis was verified for analyzing different cases. The first case is that when this custom unit is working or not, it's the pink one indicated on the diagram below. This diagram presents the time and the working condition which were obtained from the knowledge about the company just to verify how the algorithm can work. So we have the first condition that is this generation working or not? Then what's the reconfiguration? I mean, the reconfiguration was concerned that somebody changed something manually, that the, for example, the welding machine was not supplied from the first transformer, but from the other. And then the maintenance break. And in this point, I would like to say that the algorithm was sensitive for all this working condition of mining industry. So in fact, it classified the data by the different working condition. But as I had a knowledge about the mining industry, however, during the classification, one other unknown condition was indicated. And for, so in this point, I would like to show that the increasing number of cluster just let us know the working condition, the different impact for the classification. For those one who are interested in power quality, I included the information and the comparison between the cluster. And I mean, in this point, the classification is some kind of the quality. Now we have the groups. Each of the cluster is a group of data that have the features. I mean, the mean, the minimal, the maximal, the medium value that are connected in one cluster. And then we can make the quality assessment and say that the cluster one, which represents the working condition in which distributed generation is working, may be analyzed like the moment in which the power quality has a positive impact, I don't know, in point of voltage, but the negative impact was connected with the harmonics. So, but still the data mining analyze it, but still there is an expert who needs to give an information. What is the output? Why this cluster was obtained? But there are also the possibility to present why the classification was obtained. I mean, we had the input parameter, which consists of 14 parameters from 4 different measurement points. So the question is, which parameter was the most significant that we obtained this classification, not other? And how to analyze it is connected with analyzing importance rates of the parameters. And then we can say, okay, for us, only, I don't know, 10 or 20 from this 15 parameters are important. So for future, we just may look for some optimization, how to decrease our input matrix of data. And I just make this this one case in which I recalculated 3 face-to-face values into 1 mean value. Of course, in this point, we can say we can take minimum, maximum, extra, or some median value that would describe the 3 similar values to obtain 1. And in this point, I would like to say that we decrease from 14 parameters to 6 parameters for each measurement point. And generally, the classification classified and indicate the same working condition, expect the deviation into 2 clusters. And also the classification successful was at the level of the 95%. So in this point, I know that for majority of you, the problem of power quality is not so obvious. But in this point, I would like to say that this analysis of power quality was just the example to show in which problem we have to consider during analysis our data. And I think that the positive element of this lecture was that the data mining may be successfully applied. And I hope that I just make a small introduction and analyze what problems you may meet during analysis your data in different area of life. And I think that's also including showing the using the Chebyshev or Euclidean distance to make the difference between our cluster also show that we have to consider before we start our deviation, what is the aim of our research. And also it's important that we as a human are still need to make a qualitative assessment of this elements that we obtain automatically by using data mining techniques. And also, I would like to say that all the presented information are included in these three articles. And finally, I would like to invite to publish your own research in the special issue in energies that concern mining, machine learning and data mining application in power system. If any of you will be interested, I would like to invite to send your own research paper. And now, as I was asked to, there is the time for a question. So thank you for attention. If you have any question, feel free to ask.
Yes, if any participant has any question or query, they can ask or they can write it into the chat box. There is one question from the chat box that how data mining and data science different. So can you see this chat box?
Yes, I can see the chat box. Well, to answer this question, I think there is a difference between the definitions. And in this point, I really don't feel qualified to make short and real response to this issue because I'm focused on data mining and the information about this, in fact, applied so in this point, I don't know how data science is defined. So for me, it's hard to say what is the difference, but I think that these two elements are connected similar. I mean, to obtain the information from the data. And I think that the core issue is the same, to obtain knowledge from the data. But what is the technical difference in this point? I cannot give the sure response. So sorry for not answering, but I would like not to make the mistake in this point. Are there any questions, any more questions?
I think there is no more questions.
Okay. So thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for a wonderful session. I would like to thank you for accepting our invitation. And I would also like to thank the management of ITMSLS Baroda University for giving this wonderful opportunity. Thank you all the participants for attending this session. Thank you, everyone. Have a good day.
Thank you very much. Have a good day.